Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mangs, and I welcome you guys back to some more randomized Fire Emblem 8. It's time to take on this chapter right here, the defense map. This is actually a really cool chapter. Again, a really cool chapter, but one that was kind of overshadowed by very easy difficulty. I dare say it's actually going to be really hard now. We need to survive for 11 turns, but the boss is right here. His name is Ayaz, and he drops a knight's crests, and his stats are pretty terrifying, but he doesn't have ranged weapons. However, we really want to kill him, naturally. I always like it when defense chapters do this. Like, you're stacked against overwhelming odds, but if you somehow actually manage to kill the boss, you get a special reward. That's always a very nice incentive to push the player to move forward in defense chapters, and I really like that. He's surrounded by three very nasty dudes, three rangers. They got really terrifying base stats. And, yeah, there's a lot of enemies around here. And I do believe Cormac shows up here somewhere around mid-chapter. And needs to be recruited by Erica. So I hope he's a class that can move in mountains, or he's going to be stuck here. And also, mini-boss Pablo, the guy we killed last chapter, he also shows up here somewhere down the line. Although, in the vanilla version of Fire Emblem, I usually clear this chapter before he gets a chance to show up. So that's kind of funny. But yeah, this is actually a really cool chapter, and I've already done the battle preparation, so let's just go. So what I'm going to do right here is... I'm going to turn off Seth's animations, because he's going to do a lot of shit on enemy face. I'm going to send Seth into this fort right here. And I'm going to be equipping the Brave Bow. And the idea is that he's going to get surrounded. But the idea is that I'm going to try to take down these three guys. Because I'm pretty sure I'll get surrounded by Armor Knights and Soldiers. And then the Rangers will attack me with their bows. And hopefully... I mean, Seth's base stats are pretty good. He will get doubled by some of them. But hopefully he should be able to at least damage them a little bit. Meanwhile, I'm just going to focus on... taking down the archers around me, so I don't take any more ballista hits than I need to. And there's also some nice experience for the archer also. I'm gonna send Sailor down here to eat up this guy. Maybe I should send Sailor around like so. That could work. Let's use the Hellfang. Ruff! I don't even know why he has a Fiery Fang on him. The Hellfang is just objectively better, since he has the con to wield it. There's really no... I mean, maybe the... Maybe the Fire Fang has slightly better hit. I think it might have slightly better hit. Anyway, I'm going to send Garcia and Gilliam down here to take down these soldiers. Maybe I should send Gilliam first. And I know that this guy has a javelin. So what... I can trade over to a hand axe now that I think about it. Yeah, I can trade over to a hand axe after I'm done attacking, which is always a nice little thing you can do. So again, this is a defense chapter, and that means the best way to approach it is just to try and kill as many enemies as possible. That is usually the best way to tackle defense chapters, if you have the ability to. Doink. Meh. See, what kind of affinity does Gilliam have anyway? He has the Thunder affinity. That gives a void, I think, and crits? So it's not fantastic. Alright. Anyway, I'm gonna send Mulder over here. Try to take down... Oh, nice one, Mulder. Good job. Because, as I said, I want to take out the archers quickly. I'll use the Hellfang. I don't know why I'm carrying the Fetid Claw. It's absolutely useless. I think it is just worse than the Hellfang in every single way. It's heavier, less accurate, and deals less damage. But hey. And Innes does have a Horse Slayer, or Whore Slayer, as some people have been making fun of me for pointing out. So maybe we should be a little bit careful here. I think we can actually move him over here if we want to. But we want to stay outside the ballista range, that's for sure. So we can probably move Erica down here. We do want to keep Erica around because Cormag will show up eventually. And it would be nice to be in range to recruit him when he does. I guess we can get some experience on Erica then. Well, we can try. Alright, so again, gotta stay outside the ballista range. Joshua's not gonna be able to do a tremendous amount here. But at least we want Ford to move into range here. So he can do some stealing. Alright, this should work. So yeah, this is why I turned off animations for him. He's gonna get surrounded now by a lot of dudes. Just as I thought he would. And hopefully... He should be able to retaliate on the Rangers, hopefully. We'll have to see. Ah, you cheeky little bugger. You move on to the forge. Should have predicted that. Will it help him, though? Nope. It will not. Nice one. This guy goes for Gilliam. Maybe... Yeah, that's a nice kill for Erica to pick up, actually. So that's good. We can probably move Gilliam and Garcia away from those guys now. Alright, guy attacks from the fort. Ah, Seth retaliates. Of course he does. That kind of sucks. Wastes two uses of the brave bow right there. That kind of sucks. No! Ow! What the fuck? You're awful, soldier. Yeah, one of the rangers goes in for the melee hits. That kind of sucks. But I did bring an elixir, so... Seth does decently, but he does get doubled by these guys. Ow. Okay, I am pushing it right here. He definitely needs his elixir on the next turn. Oh, what's this? No! Oh, crap. Okay, it's fine. He missed. Seth's resistance is pretty good, so... I think we're fine here. Alright, we'll get some reinforcements right there. So yeah, Seth will need to work his magic right now. He could, like... I could try to shoot down some of these guys, or try to kill one of them, but I think it's probably for the best if I just drink an elixir. There we go. I could also try to lure these guys into attacking elsewhere, I mean... Let's see... this guy has a movement of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I could position Innes right here, but I'm pretty sure he'll get doubled. It would be nice, though, for one of them to go... I could, like, attack this guy with Mulder. Mulder actually does not get doubled, which is kind of funny. Anyway, this is a kill for Erica. As I said, I'm gonna try to keep her in the area. Oh, what? No, 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 no. Fuck. I'm an idiot. Alright, we definitely did not see that. Oh my god, I'm such a fucking goof. Alright, so I restarted. And this time around, Seth actually did not take that much damage on this phase. So I'm gonna try to see if I can kill one of the rangers. And I can! So that's lovely. Even get a level up out of that, which is pretty sweet. Alright, so that's... Oh, nice one! Hit points, speed, luck, and resistance. Lovely. So that's one less ranger to worry about. I'm pretty sure we can... Yeah, we can draw one of the soldiers out with Larachel. And I think it's definitely time for... This guy will pretty much... This guy will pretty much go for Sela anyway. So maybe we can actually trick him. Like, can Sela double this guy? He has 22 speed, so he cannot. So, okay, we're actually going to move Sela down here for now. We're going to see if Erica can get this kill. Broom. Let us see if she can get this kill. She can. And that probably means we can move Mulder and Garcia back to the front lines. Any healing to be done right here? Seems like it. Alright, level up for Kyle. Will he ever stop being terrible? Nope! I mean, what the shit? Why are you so goddamn bad? Okay, so these reinforcements right here. We have a hand axe guy. And we have a droppable Sambato. I actually definitely want that. Seems like I'm gonna have to get attacked by both of them regardless of what I do. So let's equip a javelin. Well, that Sambato would make a fine addition to Larachel. Yeah, Larachel could definitely use that. That would be nice. Alright, we can't really deal with those rangers, so we're gonna have to stay out of their range for now until Seth can somehow magically take them down. What was that? Oh, that was just armor knights. Alright. So yeah, I hope you guys understood why I decided to disable his animations, because, yeah, this is gonna take a very long time. But yeah, I'm pretty sure Joshua doubles this guy, even with a javelin. So if we can kill him, I'm pretty sure Joshua's inventory is full. Okay, no, he actually does not double with the javelin, but we'll kill him on the next turn. Anyway, this is nice. Ooh, good job, Larachel. Good job, Larachel. Getting a lot of experience against this guy. God, if I can promote her I'm pretty sure she will be absolutely insane. Although she will be locked to swords, that's like gonna be her major weakness. She's gonna become like a free knight. I do like free knights, even though they're locked to swords. I don't know why, I always like them. Tristan did become pretty good in my substitute run. Doink, doink. Alright, we will retaliate on this guy. Let's just hope we don't get put to sleep. Ah! Crap, alright, here comes the sleep. Please miss. He has like a 10% chance to hit. So, Seth's resistance is actually very respectable. Alright, so this turn, there is absolutely no doubt what we have to do. We have to... How much does the Brabo weigh anyway? It weighs 12. Seth can use that without penalty. Yeah, I can. There we go. And this kill will definitely go to a Larachal. Now what we can do is we can actually sneak around with Ford. Maybe we can pick him up with someone, such as Sele. Strength and defense, that's just the stat she needs, so I'm happy with that. I think if I pick him up, it's just too bad I don't have Kanto, I can probably like jump him somewhere away from... Okay, how far does Sele move? He moves 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So he can actually move almost outside the Ranger's range. Ranger's range. But yeah, I need to get... Like, I have plenty of turns to get there, so it's not like I need to rush. But yeah, I am going to kill this guy now. And I'm going to send the Sambato over to Erica, and we can give the Sambato... Oh, come on! A 92% hits? Are you fucking joking right now? What the shit? Alright, can we... Yeah, we can rough this guy up. Rough! Oh, look at that avoidance. Mmm, ain't touching loots. Hit points, strength. Lovely. She's almost capped strength now. I think I probably could just promote her. I mean, I don't know. 7 extra levels, will they really do much for her? Don't know. Seems like she needs to be promoted, though. Alright, so we can't move inside... We need to kill these rangers before we do anything else. There's not like we can do a whole lot. We can try to throw an axe at this guy. It's not gonna work. I mean, can fly up with Erica. Just gotta be careful because this guy has a hand axe. No, wait, he doesn't. Oh, okay. All right then. I still would like to keep Erica outside his range, though. We can do that with a javelin, so that's fine. Alright, so we got the Sambato. Went to Erica anyway. That's cool. Hey, we could give it to Gilliam. Garcia. Garcia can make great use of that thing. Let us do that. You can have the Iron Sword, I suppose. Alright. That is good. That is good. Yeah, Gilliam can make... or Garcia can make great use of that. So do we just... I don't know. What do we do with this Ranger? Do we just lure him out with Moldra? I mean, Moldra has the speed to not get doubled by the guy. The guy has how much crit? He has 9 crits. Moldra's luck is 2, so that's a small chance to get critted. Which is not good. But he does have a Vanessa support. That's right. Oh, fuck. That kind of sucks. Oh, my God. I mean, if I keep Gilliam within Moldra's range, then that's 3 spaces. That's a B support. Gilliam has Thunder Affinity, which I do believe gives Crit Avoid. So let's try to make them attack Moldra, shall we? Let's do it. Let's equip the Elfire Tome. Can even keep Innes close by in case things go awry. Awry? Is that how you say it? Ori? Arai? I don't know. I don't fucking know. Gotta stop using words I don't know how to pronounce. Alright, so... Alright, let's see if they actually go for Moldra. I think maybe the bow guy will be enticed to, since... No, okay, never mind. Okay, those are the armor knights, sorry. Maybe I should just equip the hand axe and start killing these guys now. I don't know. We'll have to see. Ugh. Okay, that actually kind of hurts. I'm a little bit worried about the axe guy now. Oh, never mind. The Hellfang doesn't double. Wow, that's a first. Ow. I gotta keep Eunice around here, though, just in case, because, as I said, Pablo will arrive from the west with a shit ton of dudes, and I do believe there's some stealables there as well, so if I want the red gem, I'll need to work hard for it. Alright, will they go for Molder? Will they go for Molder? No, that guy will go for Seth, because he can't get retaliated upon, but the other guy, no, he'll go for Seth. Oh, nice one. Oh, that could be a kill. Alright, please don't sleep me, please don't sleep me, please don't sleep me, please don't sleep me. Yes! Good job, good job. You little fucker! Okay, that's it. I'm killing that guy. I am actually starting to wonder if that stealable red gem isn't worth it. I mean, I need to get... There are some really nice stealables over here. A body ring, for instance. I think I want the body ring more than I want the, I want the body ring a lot more than I want that other crap. I do. I want the body ring a lot more than I want that other crap. So, is this where I just... I don't know. The brave bow doesn't have any durability left on it. Maybe it's time to just kill shit right now. It's not like I get to kill this shit anyway, right? Alright, let's just do it. Kill the healer. That was the red gem, so fuck that shit. We need to get Sailor over here now. Although I would like to try and kill the boss. The question is, like, can I... I don't know, is it even any point in trying to? I mean, I could dump him off here, certainly. It will bring the other guys away. I think I will, actually, because Sailor has pretty fantastic avoidance. Bringing the rangers away would actually be good for me. We can put Molder over here. Maybe that will entice the rangers to go for him. But yeah, we need to get Ford back west, because we want to steal that body ring. That's more important to me than the red gem, and I'm pretty sure we killed the guy with the red gem anyway. But the question is, can Sailor kill the boss? He does 30 damage. He has 22 speed, so he doesn't double the boss. Oh, actually, wait, no, he totally does. Actually, I think Sailor will rape this guy. Alright, good job. Let's hope that happens. Anyway, we got some easy experience to get right here. Erica can use the Axe Reaver to land a kill right here. Loot took a lot of damage from that guy, so we gotta be really careful about this. Garcia can probably step in right here. That is not very healthy. Iron Axe, Iron Sword. That's fine. As long as we send loot back, we should be fine. There we go. And I'm pretty sure Cormac shows up soon. Skill, speed, and defense. Awesome. Capped speed right now. I think we'll hand over the Samba Toe to Lauachel now. She can probably make better use of it. Alright, we'll wait here. The Rangers might go for Sailor now, because he can't attack back, which is actually a good thing. Anyway, Seth is pissed. He doesn't want to deal with this crap anymore. He's like, I got my hand axe now, bitches. Maybe I should have given Seth the halberd. He could have tried to take down the boss. Might have been a good idea, actually. Anyway, Joshua's now got capped speed, so I'm pretty sure he doubles everything now. He's gonna become a death coil soon. Death coils have really fucking savage looking animations. Yep. Yep. Alright, awesome. That's some easy kills for Lauratchel to pick up. Okay, now this guy is like, fuck Seth. I want to have a chance at the boulder. And the boulder levels up. He leveled hit point, skill, speed, and defense. Doesn't want to level magic, of course. That's for wusses. Rough. Rough. Who let the dogs out? Do, 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 do. OK. Okay, the ballista key. Oh, keep shooting at Innes. I gotta be careful or else Innes dies. Okay. Alright. Interesting. Oh, crap. He doubles. Oh, that's right. Ford is actually slow as fuck. Yeah, Ford is super slow. Oh, balls. Balls. They both double Ford. Well, at least I drew them. Oh my god, I'm so fucking lucky. Holy crap. I am so god-awful lucky. Oh, hello. Alright, so there's Cormag, and he's stuck in the mountains. Okay, that's lovely. Let's take a look at Cormag, shall we? So Cormag's a lord. That either means he's really good or really bad. I actually can't remember, but he's carrying an Elysian whip, which is nice. Wow, there's actually some pretty solid base stats on him. Cormag's, of course, got really good growths. He's arguably, in my opinion, one of the best flyers in the game. And that's a tough title, because there's a lot of good flyers in Fire Emblem 8. As a lord, he could work. You do get one Ephraim bracelet and one Erica bracelet, so you can theoretically have both a lord and a lordette, as I like to call them. Those are not bad stats at all. 14 base strength, 13 base speed. He is level 11. 9 cons, a little low for a lance wielder. But I don't think he, like, I don't think this is gonna be a bad deal. Maybe we should try using him. I think we can try using him. Of course, we need to go speak to him with Erica. We need to go and, yeah, we need to be careful about these guys. They have javelins. We could draw them out with a ranged attacker, probably. But first, let's see what we're gonna do here. Ah, these guys are so fucking strong. One thing's for sure, Ford needs to get the fuck away from here. Like, he's never gotten the fuck away from anything before, really. Is this a safe space for him? It is, actually. And we can heal him up with Molder, thank god. And I think we're just gonna stick sail around here. Wow, these guys are way too scary. At least we can do some damage to them. Problem is, there's healers around, and they're gonna be a bitch to take on. I should have given Seth the freaking halberd. I don't know why I didn't do that. So is this a viable choice? The guy has a silver axe. He doesn't have a ranged weapon. But it would be nice to take him out. Should have given him the halberd. That was stupid of me. At least a good melee axe, at the very least. But I think I'm gonna start chipping him down. It is over. It's gonna be over in a couple of turns. So yes, that's gonna be pretty good here. Oh, this guy doesn't even have any healing staves. What's cool about... Oh, crap. Yeah, this guy's gonna go for Molder now. So we gotta be really careful about this. I should definitely keep Gilliam in range. Although, what would be nice... Yeah, I'm gonna try to lure that Wyvern out with Gilliam's hand axe, and I'm still in support range of Molder, so that's really good. We're gonna try to stay away from these guys, or I'm gonna try to move Larachel up here and deal with this guy. She has pretty sound avoidance in the forests. And she does have that ever so nice Joshua support as well, which is nice. This guy has what? He has a iron axe and an iron sword. Larachel has 70 avoid on this mountain pass, which is really kick-ass. But yeah, I'm gonna prepare to recruit Cormag, but I need to move in range of, or just outside the range of that Wyvern Knight. Like so. While staying outside the ballista range, of course. Let's all back. Oh, I could have healed Innes. That was stupid of me. Shouldn't have done that. Guess we can move back and drink an elixir then. And I also think I want to switch over to a better weapon for Joshua. Maybe I could give him a kill. Nah, I'm not going to give him a killer lance. Alright, so this should work. Actually, fuck. I should have moved Erica closer. What am I doing? I'm an idiot. Alright, it's fine, though. Ah. Be nice with Molder. He is tanky, though, so he should be fine. No, my Hellfire! No! I wonder if Garcia gets doubled by this guy. No, he doesn't. Nobody gets doubled by soldiers. Oh, nice one. Good job, Seth. Good job, Seth. Right, this is good. Joshua and Lauachal, I think, have a B-rank support now. And that really shows. So I think Lauachal is boosting Joshua quite a bit in terms of damage output, which is nice. All right. Although it would be nice if he didn't kill these guys so Lauachal could pick up the pieces. Alright, soon gonna level up. What level is Joshua anyway? I've forgotten. Okay, wow, all those cavalier reinforcements, Jesus. Should probably check for halberds and shit, or horse layers. They're cavaliers, they can't wield halberds, but still. Should be careful, because they could have special weapons on them. Anyway. So there's no way I'm gonna be able to kill all these guys anyway. I don't feel bad about letting Seth have a lot of experience here. Might as well, right? It's not like they would have been able to. I could potentially have picked this one up with other guys, but I needed to get the rangers out of the way, because the rangers pretty much just prohibit anyone from moving around. And that guy has to be out of ammo soon. Jesus. Alright. Luckily, they do not double sail, which is good. And that other guy who took damage. No, they'll still go for sail, okay. Interesting. Even though Mulder was in range, probably because Sele can't attack back, but I'm locking up the knights, which is nice. I don't know if killing the boss ends the map or not. I'm actually really unsure. I don't think I can move Sele away. Okay, this is good. Wow, this guy's tanky. Holy shit. Oh, nice one, Gilliam. Oh my god, that's perfect. Holy shit. That's really good. Alright. Does that mean Erica can pick up the kill? It actually means she can. What the fuck? Alright, that's good. That's really good. What? Come on. Really? At least she dinged. Hit points, skill, and speed. Eh, that's fine. What the shit? That's some bullshit right there. Holy crap. Alright, we need to do some damage against these guys, or else they'll never go down. I don't think there's any more Wyvern Knights coming from the mountain, though. Wait a minute. If I talk to Cormag, does these guys turn green? I'm actually not sure if they do. I completely forgot to check that. Anyway, Erica can recruit him on the next turn, so that's good. And Lauachal can take out this guy. Probably shouldn't be using the rapier for this, but it's such a nice accurate weapon, and I got two of them. They're pretty much exclusive to her anyway, so it's not like I can use them on anyone else. And I like having like reliable weapons that okay, before I start healing, I need to make sure that I can actually kill all these guys. Dun 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 dun. Well, we can use the killing edge here. Oh, let me see the awesome rogue crit. Come on. Let me see the awesome rogue crits. Yes! So I think pretty much my best strategy right now is to kill Pablo on the turn he spawns, because he comes with quite a large group of soldiers. A pretty large bunch of them, if I remember correctly. This should be a kill. And Gilliam is very close to reaching his promotion right now. Yep. Hit points. Oh, level speed. Fucking love it. I love the fact that he's so fucking fast. Anyway, let us heal up Erica first. I think, yeah, we'll just keep Sele here. We'll definitely just keep Sele here. We'll keep chipping down the boss. We'll kill him eventually. We'll probably kill him before turn 11. Again, I can't remember if killing the boss actually ends the map, so I want to be a little bit careful here. Ruff. And I'm pretty sure Innes is getting benched really soon, because his base stats are just not worth keeping him around as a pre-promote. Bottom. Bottom. Da-da-da-dum. You want to die? Maybe I should just turn off Sale's animation as well. He's just going to keep taking arrows from those rangers the rest of the map. That is pretty much going to be his role. And Seth is just gonna kill all the reinforcements. Oh, how I love you, Seth. You're so fucking amazing. Dun 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 do da la boo da. Actually, they could quickly kill him if he's a little bit unlucky. They have like a 50% chance to hit him. That's not good. Although this guy, not so. Ow! Okay, and he's the guy that actually ends up hitting. Not good, not good. It's definitely a little bit of an RNG to keep sailing around there. This guy won't do shits. But yeah, Sailor's being very useful. He's locking them up. Just too bad he can't counterattack. If he could counterattack, he'd be amazing. I say that, and suddenly a bunch of just javelins. Javelins, javelins, javelins. Fucking hate javelins. Alright. So yeah, we'll keep him around. He does have a Vulnerai on him. He'll survive. He'll be fine. Alright, keep chipping on the boss. Can actually kill him next turn, but then again, I'm really uncertain if that ends them up or not. Anyway, let's go and recruit Cormag. So he is recruited. He, of course, can't move. I'm going to have to pick him up. I think I'm just going to get ready for... Yeah, I'm just going to get ready for Pablo right now. Just going to... Because he doesn't move on the turn he shows up. I don't think there's any ambush bonds and sacred stones. One of the things I really like about the game. So yeah, I'm just gonna fucking ambush him on the turn he shows up. I think it's the next turn, but I can't remember. No, I'm not sure if you can block his spawn either. I'm gonna be careful. Pretty sure he shows up at the shows up at the end of the enemy phase. I'm pretty sure on the next turn. So we'll see. Seth still has his elixir, so he'll be fine. Oh, you want to die, little archer? And I also think Pablo dropped something. Does he drop a guiding ring? No, I dropped a guiding ring last chapter, I think. He does definitely have something on him that we want. Hit points, skill, speed, oh my god, Seth. Such godlike level ups, oh my god. Yeah, Sail is keeping the two range guys busy over here. Pro strats. Wonder if I perhaps should do an elixir with Seth this turn. Might be a good idea. Alright, still no Pablo. That's good. That's good. That gives us another turn to set up this ambush. And yeah, you can just... Okay, there's no one bulky enough to take him. There we go. Alright, lovely. So let's heal up forward. We are patiently awaiting Pablo's arrival, ladies and gentlemen. This is silly. Oh my god, so stupid. I know he's gonna show up eventually. Alright, I think I'm just gonna bide my time and just do this. Alright, we'll be fine. Doo-doo. Rabababum. Now they're running away to heal. My god, how many people have Seth killed this episode? Probably over half of the enemies. Nice one! Oh, that 5% crit from the S-rank Axe Master gives you so many extra crits. Alright, Sailor, as long as you dodge the Steel Bow guy, you should be fine. That's the Iron Bow guy. That's the Steel Bow guy. That's the Javelin guy, that doesn't matter. Alright, here he is. That's a lot of dudes. That's a lot of fucking dudes. Oh my god, can we kill all these guys in one hit? Oh my god, really? Holy fuck, that's a lot of dudes. Shite. I am not sure if I can kill Pablo, to be quite honest. Eek. Okay, there's the stealable body ring. Can I even... As long as I take down the dangerous guys, I suppose I should be fine. Hmm. Wow, this guy is scary. Holy shit. Oh my god, what the hell? What the hell have I gotten myself into right now? This is crazy. Oh my god, at least we got Cormag. I'm starting to think I'm not gonna be able to kill these guys. I do double. Oh my god, that guy is scary. What the hell? What? Oh my god, well, at least Larachel is able to take out this guy. I guess we're just going with it. I mean, we need to kill Pablo. And I have no idea how. Don't have any status saves or anything. Hit points, strength, speed. At least that's a good level up. Oh crap, how can I even deal with it? He does have a Sword Slayer. So that means he should be weak to lances, right? Can Innes kill this guy? He cannot. He can deal some good damage to this guy, though. He'll die. He'll definitely die. It's too bad his con is so bad. This is a tricky nut to crack. Loot does not have what it takes to double this guy. He's a little bit too fast, or she gets weighted down a little bit too much. If I can kill this mage with someone, like Ford, then Innes could move around and take the horse dude. Yeah, I guess that will have to do. And what can I do, honestly, at this point? I might lose someone. I didn't know there would be that many. As long as I don't kill the guy with the body ring, I should be fine. Okay, he can't ride around. Of course he can't. Well, Joshua needs to take down this guy. He cannot. Innes, you're in the way. Wow, Pablo doesn't take any damage from this guy. What the hell? It's 13 speed, 15 speed. This is terrible. This warrior is dangerous as fuck. Garcia could get it. Okay, I'm just gonna fucking bank on a Garcia crit right here. Oh my god, he got it. Oh wait, no, fuck, that's the this is the guy with the body ring I was gonna steal. Oh no. That was the body ring I was gonna steal. Well, fuck. God fucking damn it. Well, I need to kill this guy, but I can't kill him with Innes. Well, if I can attack him first with loots, he'll have a pretty good... Nah, it's better to have Innes die right here. Oh my god, how can I even get out of this mess? This is gonna be such a nasty enemy face. These guys were way too strong. I should have just waited them out. I couldn't try to kill the boss, actually. Oh, what? Oh, wait, no, the Fire Fang, I'll do it. Don't counter, please. Ah, he countered. I'm so fucked. I'm gonna have to kill the boss now on this turn. I hope killing the boss ends the chapter. I don't think it does, but I hope it will. Ooh, a crit here would be godlike. I'm not gonna get it, though. Ouch. Nope. Okay, come on. Fucking hell. Ow. Ah. Am I actually able to kill this? Oh my god, I'm able to kill this guy. I am actually able to kill this guy. No. What? No. The support. I fucked up. The support. I fucked up this. No! It's okay, Joshua's still able to do something right here. Well, one thing's for sure, I need to get Erica the fuck out of here. She get murdered by this guy. Wow, Eric. Actually, you know what? This is fine, Erica can kill him. There we go. Oh my god, this fucking map right here is crazy. I'm crazy, what the fuck am I doing? And yeah, I'm aware I could have gotten that Sword Reaver. I am fully aware of that. Pablo actually has a slim lance, interestingly enough. Huh. Gilliam doubles. Interesting. Does he double the mage? He does. All right, cool. Please kill this guy. Please hit. Thank you. Oh my god. Perfect. Ugh, are we gonna be able to do this, Shin? Are we actually gonna be able to do this, Shin? This guy has 11 speed, so he doubles Kyle. He does 22 damage. Kyle has 9 defense. That's 13 times 2 actually won't kill me. Interesting. I actually managed to take down most of them, interestingly enough. If I had Erika's Axe Weaver right here, I could have killed this guy as well. But no, I need to keep Joshua on here. I'm actually gonna attack this guy. That didn't help. Alright, I'm actually gonna try and kill the boss right now, because Pablo doesn't drop anything. Fuck, I forgot to steal the body ring. That's annoying. It's really annoying. But yeah, I'm gonna kill the boss now with the steel bow. I missed. Of course I missed. Alright, so who dies, ladies and gentlemen? Who dies today? Who dies today? Loot, probably? Maybe? Pretty sure she's gonna attract most of the dudes, but her avoidance is pretty fucking good, though. So if I'm really lucky... Oh, please level, like, luck or something. Come on. Ah. Defense wouldn't have helped her out anyway. Okay, they're all gonna go for her now. Oh my god. Oh, please get surrounded so none of the other guys... Okay, they're all going for her now because she has low health. This could be a blessing in disguise. The problem is Pablo, of course. Pablo's the big problem! Oh my god, she's probably gonna survive. Oh my god. It depends on who Pablo goes for, to be quite honest. Because Pablo can probably kill a lot of the dudes in my army. If he moves, though. I'm pretty sure he moves. Oh my god, please don't kill my loot. Oh, thank you. Wow, loot being at low health was actually the best thing that could have happened. I'm a little bit sour about the body ring, but honestly, okay, crap. Just don't kill Sailor now, please. Ah! Oh no. Oh no! Jesus fucking Christ. Ah! Oh my god. Okay, what's gonna happen right here? Okay. Ow. Ow. Your brother did go out like that. Well, guess we're not using Cormag, ladies and gentlemen. Oh crap, he had a whip. Oh, I missed. Oh fuck, no, I missed out on a whip. Oh, that's awful. Oh, alright. Fucking hell. Well, it could have been a lot worse. Actually, it could have been way worse. Alright, so... How do I even kill this fucker? This guy is super scary, oh my god. Do I have any Worm Slayers in my inventory? I can't even fucking check. I think I have a Worm Slayer, don't I? Rachel might be able to do something. Oh, Jesus. Oh, she does do 15 damage to the guy, though, and he has like an 80% chance to hit her. That is kind of nice. Okay, we need to surround him with tough units. That is what we need to do. We need to surround him with tough units. We also need to kill this guy. As long as we surround him with tough units that can survive a round of combat for him, we should be fine. Ines does not survive. Just occurred to me that a lot of the dudes in my army are not going to be able to survive a round of combat. But Laracho might actually be able to do it. Like, she can do 15 damage to the guy. But I think it's probably better if we use her to do this. Though I'm pretty sure that the map ends when you kill the boss. So we shall see now if that is the case. Garcia cannot survive here, so we are just gonna get him out of there. Come on, get a crit. Nope. Can't even fucking hit with an 89%er. But, still enough to level him up, though. To be quite honest, though. Looks like... Oh, wow. Hit points, strength, skill, defense. I was just about to say it's probably time for this old fuck to retire soon, but... And he goes about it, surprises me with that shit. I think we'll just leave him, to be quite honest. Does he kill Molder? He doesn't double Molder, so that's the thing. He does not double Molder, and I'm pretty sure he doesn't double Joshua either. So we can probably keep Joshua around like this. I could have attacked him, to be quite honest. I could have attacked him if I wanted to. Can I rescue Erica with Ford? I can. So what I can do, so I can still fuck this guy over. You kind of want to do that, although I could do it the other way around. Probably better. Come on, let me see that sweet rogue crits. Lovely. Alright, then we need to pick up Ford because he gets decimated by Pablo. So I didn't get a lot of the things that I wanted to get out of this map, but I'm still not completely unhappy about how it went down. I'm not going to talk like it's over though, but it might be. Very impressive. So does the map end? It does. Okay. Rouse the knights? What the fuck? You get 5,000 gold. Is that, what's this? War funds? I don't know, Larchel. I honestly have no idea. Whew. That was a pretty tense map. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And, yeah. It's gonna be fun to see what happens next. Either way, I'm done now. Please consider leaving a like and a comment if you enjoyed this part. It does help out the channel ever so much. And as always, my name has been Mangs, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.